While you can use numerous tips to enhance readability, there are always instances you may fail to notice the complexity of your sentences. Tools like Hemingway are an excellent way to make your work easily understandable to readers. Now, there are many functions Hemingway Editor offers, including showing adverbs, highlighting passive voices, plus indicating complex sentences and phrases. Moreover, you can decide to write on the platform. You can also bold sentences, italicize sections, use proper heading hierarchy, quotes, add bullets or numbers, and also add links. In this video, I'm going to show you how to utilize Hemingway Editor. Welcome. So you'll come here and type Hemingway on your Chrome browser. Enter. Then we'll click on Hemingway Editor. This is what displays when you open the app. So you'll come and delete this text. Let me just cut it because I hadn't copied text. So you'll come and delete that text. Once you've deleted it, you just come and paste whatever text you have. So I'm just going to paste whatever was there. Then you'll notice that on this side, you can see the adverbs, the passive voices, the phrases that are tough, and the hard sentences and the very hard sentences. So for example, this is a hard sentence. The app highlights lengthy complex sentences and common errors. If you have a yellow sentence, shorten or split it. So we can make this sentence simpler by putting a full stop. You see, the hard sentence has disappeared. Then this is a very hard sentence. If you see a red highlight, your sentence is so dense and complicated that your reader will get lost trying to follow its meandering, splitting logic. Try editing this sentence to remove the red. If you see a red highlight, your sentence is so dense and complicated. Let's put a full stop there and delete that. So we'll begin from, your reader will get lost trying to follow its meandering, splitting logic. Then we put a full stop. Then try editing this sentence to remove the red. So we can make this into another paragraph. Then utilize, it will indicate the simpler phrases you can use. So we'll just click on use. And we are through with that. You can see there are no more sentences that require simpler alternatives. Then adverbs and weakening phrases are helpfully shown in blue. These are adverbs. So we have met the goal here, three or less, but you can see that adverbs and weakening phrases are helpfully shown in blue. We can delete this helpfully and still relay the same message. So are shown, we can also shorten that and simply say appear in blue, and we have deleted that adverb. Then get rid of them and pick words with force, perhaps. We can also delete perhaps and still relay the same message. So in most cases, the adverbs you can eliminate and still relay the same message. Then phrases in green have been marked to show passive voice. So instead of have been marked to show, we can simply say phrases in green show passive voice. Show passive voice. Yes, and as you can see, this section is clear. Then this one indicates your readability. So the more you remove tougher words, tougher phrases, and tougher sentences, the better your readability score gets. Then in this upper section, you'll notice that there is the option to bold. So maybe I want to bold this sentence, for example. Phrases in green show passive voice. Maybe I want to bold that. So I simply select it and I click on bold. You can see it's bolded. Then italizing, the same case. Just select the phrase you want to italize and click on italize. Let's make this our H1. So we'll just come and place my cursor anywhere. Then I click on H1. You see? just become H1. Then maybe I want to indicate that this phrases in green show passive voice, maybe I want that to be my H2, so I will just select there and click on H2. But that is not a H2, of course, because it doesn't make sense. The content under it doesn't make sense. So you'll just edit your article depending on what you have. If you want to turn back to normal text, you just select again and click on the H2, the hierarchy you had chosen. Then if you want to quote something, just select that paragraph and click on quotes. As you can see, it's turned into a quote. Then when you want to add bullets, the same thing. Just select whatever you want to convert to bullets and click on yes, like that. Then numbers, the same thing. When I want to add numbers, I just select, so I can just change my bullets to numbers, as you've seen. Then link is the last feature that you can do with Hemingway. Or something new, maybe I want to link to this text, compose something new. So I just come, select the link I want to link to. Maybe I want to link to the 8 tips of improving your writing style. I select my text, then I just come and click on link. Then I paste my URL and then I save.